Today, we are ranking 7 of the most viral anti-inflammatory foods that you have seen all over TikTok or Instagram, from the worst to the best, because you have probably seen the celery juice crowd swearing it cures inflammation, or influencers that will sip on bone broth saying that it will rebuild your joints. But do these trends actually work, or are they just expensive hype? I'm Dr. Diana Girnita, a rheumatologist who spent years helping patients with joint pain and autoimmune diseases. And in this video, I'll cut through the noise, I'll separate the fact from the hype, and I will give each food a score out of 5 on how well it really fights inflammation. So let's start with the one that ranks the lowest on my list. Number 7, celery juice. The TikTokers love celery juice. People post videos all the time claiming that it flushes toxins that will heal autoimmune diseases and even cures arthritis. And it is promoted as a magical reset for inflammation. But here it is, the reality. Celery, it's a healthy vegetable. Yes, it is rich in water and it contains some antioxidants like flavonoids. But when you juice it, you lose much of the fiber. And that's the very thing that will help your gut health, and it will reduce inflammation. And unfortunately, there are no strong clinical trials to show that celery juice reverses arthritis or autoimmune conditions. At best, it will hydrate you and it will give you a little bit of vitamins. So my verdict, a glass of celery juice won't harm you, but it will not fix the inflammation either. So my score is 1.5 out of 5. We go down to number 6, turmeric lattes. Here is the hype. Golden milk looks beautiful on Instagram. That golden yellow color that claims that it will relieve joint pain and even offer immune support. But the truth is that turmeric itself does have an active compound called curcumin, and that has been shown in many studies to reduce inflammation markers. And it was even compared with anti-inflammatory medications like ibuprofen in some trials. But here is the catch. Curcumin is very poorly absorbed by your body if you just put it in the latte. To get the benefits, you most likely need higher concentrations. Usually, those are found in supplements. And it also needs to be paired with black pepper or healthy fats to improve the absorption. So most turmeric lattes have nowhere near enough curcumin to achieve that anti-inflammatory effect. My verdict, think about this golden milk or turmeric latte more as a soothing ritual than a medication or a treatment. So my score is 2 out of 5. Number 5, apple cider vinegar. Here's the hype. Apple cider vinegar is marketed in our days as a cure for all, for weight loss, for detox, for gut health, and of course for reducing inflammation. Some influencers even drink it straight every morning. But the truth is, the strongest evidence for apple cider vinegar is that it may help with your blood sugar control, particularly in people that have insulin resistance. And that will indirectly reduce inflammation, because high blood sugar will drive inflammation in the body. But when it comes to arthritis or autoimmune diseases, the evidence is extremely weak. In fact, if you drink too much vinegar, that can damage your tooth enamel, will irritate your esophagus, and it will upset your stomach. So my verdict is that it's fine to use it in moderation, especially on a salad, but it is not a magic anti-inflammatory solution. So my score is 2.5 out of 5. Number 4, matcha green tea. The hype. Matcha has become the drink. with claims of boosting energy, calming stress, and reducing inflammation. My kids will buy matcha every day if they can. But the truth is that matcha is a powder green tea, and it's especially rich in EGCG, this very complicated word, which is a powerful antioxidant studied for reducing oxidative stress and inflammation. And research even suggests that this compound, EGCG, may help protect the cartilage and reduce the risk of chronic conditions that are linked to inflammation. And unlike celery juice or apple cider vinegar, matcha has actually some peer-reviewed science backing its benefit. So my verdict, matcha is a solid daily choice if you can enjoy the taste, but be mindful of those sugary coffee shops versions. So my score is 3.5 out of 5. Number 3, chia seeds. The hype is that Instagram loves chia puddings because they are trendy, they look good in photos, and they are marketed as the anti-inflammatory breakfast. And the truth is that chia seeds really do deliver. They are one of the richest plants based in omega-3 fatty acids, which are very well known to lower inflammation in your body. But they also contain fiber, which will support the gut health and indirectly reduce inflammation. The challenge is the quantity. A teaspoon that you sprinkled on your yogurt is not enough. You need at least 2 tablespoons consistently to see the benefit. My verdict, small but mighty. Chia seeds are an easy win for your anti-inflammatory diet. So my score is 4 out of 5. Number 2, the bone broth. Bone broth is now everywhere. The marketing says that it heals your gut, it rebuilds your joints, and it will ease inflammation. And the truth is that bone broth does contain collagen, amino acids like glycine, and minerals like calcium and magnesium. And these nutrients can support the joints and the gut health in general. But here is a nuance. When you drink bone broth, your body will break down collagen down to amino acids. And not all of those will go directly into your knees to rebuild your cartilage. But there are some studies that suggest that collagen supplements often derived from similar sources, they can reduce the stiffness and they can support the joint health in some patients. So my verdict, it's not magic, but definitely more nourishing and more beneficial than most of the things that we have talked about in the earlier part of our list. So my score is 4.2 out of 5. So if bone broth comes in second, what takes the crown? It's not exotic, it's not trendy, but it's very powerful, it's affordable, and it is backed by solid science. Let's reveal number 1, berries. Berries won't go viral on TikTok the way that celery juice or bone broth will do. But ask any nutritionist, any nutritional researchers, and they will tell you that berries are one of the most or the top anti-inflammatory foods. And the truth is that berries are loaded with a lot of antioxidants that will lower that oxidative stress and will lower inflammation. And there are many studies to show that people who eat berries regularly, daily, they will have lower levels of C-reactive protein, which is one of the main markers for inflammation. They will also improve their heart health, the brain health, and they will improve their immune balance. For people with arthritis or autoimmune diseases, berries are one of the simplest but the most effective foods that you can eat every day. So here is my verdict. They might not be flashy on the social media, but when it comes to science, berries beat the hype every single time. So my score is 5 out of 5. So there you have it, from overhyped celery juice to science-backed berries. Not everything that you see online actually works for inflammation. And now that you know which foods are worth it, then the next step is to understand what foods you need to avoid to precipitate more inflammation in your body. Because if you don't get this right, no superfoods will help you. And you find everything in this video.